Good morning, to everyone. Today we are here to study the NCERT Class 10 Science Chapter 15, our environment. And my name is Rachel Pradeepa. To begin with the class, if you have to understand the environment, we have to know what an ecosystem is. An ecosystem comprises of both the biotic and the abiotic components. The biotic components are the living things. As you will see in the picture on the left side, it will include all the plants, the trees, grasses, the water plants, animals, which is the fish, bacteria, fungus, protists, and including us, the human beings. The abiotic component of the ecosystem are the non-living things, which we can identify from the picture on the left side as the water, the land or the soil, the air, the sun or the light, and the rocks, which forms the minerals. So thus the biotic and the abiotic things together forms the ecosystem, and we are also part of the environment. Having understood what an ecosystem and its components, I have given you here a picture of an ecosystem. Identify the biotic and the abiotic components and message your answers in the chat box, for which I'll give you 5 seconds. Thank you for the answers, and we will discuss them at the end of the class. So the organisms in an ecosystem are classified as producers, consumers, and decomposers. Producers are those organisms which can make their own food, and they form the largest component of all the living things on the earth. Consumers are those organisms which live on producers and on other consumers. That is, they eat other organisms for the survival, that is for food, which is the energy. So both producers and consumers depend on something which is living, or they make their own source of energy for their survival. But when they die, they are broken down into inorganic substances by the decomposers, and that is the food for the decomposers. Thus, an ecosystem will have all the three classes of organisms: producers, consumers, and decomposers, and then only it is called a living ecosystem. The consumers are further classified into different classes because they are very diverse depending on their food habits. They are classified as omnivores. For example, we human beings eat both the plants and the animals. Carnivores, like the lion, which eat only other animals, or the goat as herbivores, which eat only the plants. Parasites are a kind of carnivores. Or omnivores are a kind of carnivores because they live only on other animals for their life. But what they do is that they don't eat the whole organism. They live on the fluid of the organism or some part of the organism for their food. And they make use of a living host for their survival. Like, for example, the lice on our head or the fleas on the fur of your cats and dogs. They are all called parasites. Understanding the different classes of organisms present in an ecosystem and how they depend on each other, we have to know two terms, the food chain and the food web. A food chain is something which describes a direct and linear relationship. It is a very simple in concept to explain how each organism depends on each other. Like, for example, not all the organisms will eat the plants. Like grasshopper will eat the plant, and the grasshopper is eaten by the mice, which is eaten by the owl. And we did see that the owl and the grasshopper and the mice will form the consumer, whereas the grass will form the producer. So this linear flow of energy from the grass to the grasshopper to the mice to the owl is called the food chain. And when more than one organism are included and connected with each other to show how the food chain is existing in an environment, it appears like it is very complex and it is more interconnected, and that is why it is called a food web. So a food web will explained how all the organisms, all the living things in the ecosystem are depending on each other for food or energy, and that is called a food web. So we understand that the food chain and the food web talks about how each organism depends on each other for food or the energy. So the energy is being transferred from one organism to the other. So from where does the source of the energy comes from? The source of the energy comes from the sun or the light energy, which is tapped by the plants or the producers, and they form the largest group of the organisms on the earth. And the volume of energy that they can tap from the sun is merely 1%. And they form the bottom of the pyramid of energy, which is called the producers. And it is the first trophic level in the energy pyramid. So the different levels of energy or the grouping of organisms based on the way they consume energy from other organisms is called the trophic levels. So taking into account that all the available energy that is being formed by the producers as 100%, we find that the primary consumers which eat on the plants, they eat use only nearly 10% of the energy from the producer. So where does the rest of the 90% of the energy goes? The 90% of the energy is being used by the producers for the growth and development to form the vegetative and the reproductive structures. And beyond that, it is also used for the conversion of light energy into the available organic matter or the available energy which is formed by the producers. So this 10% of the energy which is used by the primary consumers is again being transferred to the secondary consumers at the same rate of only 10%. So these secondary consumers are merely using 1% of the energy from the producers, and so on the tertiary consumers, which is using only 0.1% of the energy from the producers, and the quaternary consumers, which is us, we are using only 0.01% of the energy from the producers. This is showing the transfer of energy from the producers to the tertiary consumers or the quaternary consumer in a linear way. Remember, we are omnivores. We also eat plants, that is the producers, and so we also use 10% of the energy in the food pyramid, in the energy pyramid. That is, we are also coming down to the level of energy, trophic level, in the primary consumers. So the energy, the organisms are scattered across the primary, secondary, and tertiary levels, depending upon what kind of organisms we are eating. So what kind of food we are consuming, if I have to put it in more simple terms. So this is the flow of energy within the living organisms. So what happens is that when these organisms die, the organic matter or the energy is being transferred to the decomposers at the same level, which is 10%, to the decomposers, and the rest of the organic matter is transferred to the earth as minerals and ashes. So the light, the minerals and ashes is not sent to the sun as light energy. So thus the transflow of energy is not a cycle in the ecosystem, and it is very linear. So having understood how the energy is transferred between the trophic levels and between the organisms, and how the organisms are grouped into different trophic levels and how they move across different trophic levels, let's understand what happens when human intervention pollutes the environment. Our activities releases toxic and chemical substances or the waste from the industries into the ecosystem, into the natural resources. Say for example, here in this case, we are talking about the release of mercury into the water as a waste. So the water which is being contaminated with mercury is transferred, or and the mercury is entering into the food chain through the food chain, into the food chain through the ecosystem that is present in the water. The plankton which is present in the water depends or absorbs the water along with the contaminated mercury, and so the mercury enters into the food chain. So when the mercury that is entering into the plankton is transferred to the aquatic insects which is feeding on the plankton, and so to the insect eating fish, the fish eating fish, and ultimately to us, the human beings. So what is happening here is that the mercury, like the energy, is also being transferred to different trophic levels or the different organisms in the food chain. And the mercury is also flowing in the same direction like how the energy is being transferred. But unlike the flow of energy, which is decreasing at every level, and so the resultant organic matter which formation which is decreasing at every level is not happening in the case of mercury. This is because the mercury is not part of the regular food or the energy that is being utilized, and it is a contaminant. So the same level of mercury is entering at every stage of the food chain or the trophic level. So what happens is that the amount of mercury is remaining the same constant, while the amount of organic matter or the energy that is flowing across the food chain is reduced at every trophic level. But this gives a very increased proportion of mercury to the amount of energy or the organic matter that is being formed across the food chain or the different trophic level. Therefore, this results in biomagnification, a deleterious effect that is happening because of introduction of toxic waste into the ecosystem. So in this class, we have understood the environment by understanding the concept of ecosystem, which is composed of biotic and abiotic components. And we are understanding in more in detail about the biotic components, which is composed of different classes of organism, the producers, consumers, and the decomposers. The consumers are further classified based on their food habits as omnivores, carnivores, parasites, and scavengers. We further understood what is food chain, what is food web, and we also understood how the flow of energy is happening between the different organisms, and so that results in classification of organism into categories, which is called the trophic levels, to form what is known as the energy pyramid. And usually there is not more than four energy levels in a pyramid. And when man interferes into this stable ecosystem by introducing toxic material, it happens to have form it happens to flow or accumulate in the into the ecosystem or spread into the ecosystem in the direction of flow of energy, but following an opposite trend, which is known as biomagnification. So let's work together to protect the environment and preserve the ecosystem. Thank you for watching and attending my class.